Jesus, he did a lot of stuff. Let me share a story in 3.5 minutes-ish. We'll kick off here. David, yeah, he's not Jesus, but he sang about him. God even tells Dave this future king was going to be part of his family tree. Dave's loving that. A few hundred years later, we meet these two. They meet shepherdy sorts and wise peeps as Mary gives birth to Jesus, then lullabies God's son to sleep in a feeding trough. Honestly, there's worse places on TripAdvisor. Then Herod hunts Jesus because he's worried the baby king rumour isn't fake news. They escape, lay low, then get the welcome home mats out in Nazareth. Phew. Mary and Joe do a home alone and lose 12-year-old Jesus. But all's good, because he's in the temple teaching the teachers. I wonder if he threw paint cans at the Pharisees. Jesus grows up, gets dunked by John, I'll eat anything Bear Grylls doesn't Baptist, and receives the spirit as Dad in Heaven makes a gushing speech. Hashtag proudest dad in the universe. Next, he's tested in the desert and has a scripture slam against Satan. Jesus smashes it. Then a wedding in Cana, miracling a vintage with water. Who needs vineyards of Bordeaux when you Jesus, eh? Good news, he makes it a fish, but the locals aren't convinced. Didn't this guy do my love conversion? Still, he does loads of epic things, too many to count in 3.5 minutes-ish, but here's 10 highlights. 1. Jesus tours Galilee and heals all sorts of people, not licorice. 2. Catches fishermen. They bowled over when this carpenter catches more fish in Captain Birdseye, so they leave their rods and follow him. Jesus, that is, not Captain Birdseye. 3. He's on a hill giving the best TED talk ever. Hashtag blessed are the ones who... Next slide, please. 4. He's on a boat that tells a storm to put a sock in it. 5. Feeds 5,000 with 5 baguettes and a couple of fish cakes. Got a ketchup. 6. Hangs out with Mary while Martha loads the dishwasher. She feels outdone by, but what's better, dishes or devotion? 7. Jesus brings dead mate Lazarus back to life. 8. Tells totes amazing stories about how God feels about us. Put on your party hats. Go all out on the buffet. My son was dead. Now he's alive. 9. After meeting little Zach on the nose from a treehouse, he rides a donkey and a bunch of palm leaves. Come on, we've all done it. Then, 10. He's at the temple and he's fuming. Jesus kicks off with the corruption and sends the payday loan scammers packing. Next, the final few days. It's Last Supper time with the team as someone tucking into the breadsticks is about to sell Jesus out. Before that, Jesus sets example and scrubs filth off his followers' feet. Then, filled to the brim with anxiety, Jesus breaks out into a blood sweat. He prays for another way but chooses the Father's way. The rabble and Judas set the betrayal in motion. He's arrested, interrogated and thrown before Pilate for the verdict. Hashtag, we want death sentence. This guy's got a Messiah complex. Pilate stalls, as does Herod, till Pilate finally backs down and washes his hands of the whole thing, crucifixion. Suffering on a cross, mess of the world on his shoulders, then it is finished. Jesus dies and is put in a tomb. 3 days later, his body vanishes, to be found. Mary thinks it's a random pot in plants, but it's not Titchmarsh, it's Jesus. He's back, raised, resurrected, alive. Back with the team, Tom's having none of it. Classic, until he sees the nail marks in Jesus' hands to prove it. Risen Jesus spends 40 days with his followers, has a beach barbecue with his fisher mates, even rambles with a couple chatting the big picture of scripture. Then it's time. Jesus clocks off so the Holy Spirit can clock on. Though the disciples won't get shortchanged from the shift change. What's better, one-time encounter or lifelong membership? He commissions the gang to be his reps everywhere, and as he takes the heavenly escalator to the right side of the Father, he simply says, wait.